If I had to come up with an alternate title for this section of scripture, I'd probably call it Seedlings and Sandcastles. Within this very short passage, there are two of my favorite analogies that I like to use to teach the kiddos that I work with. Hi, I'm Kayla, and I'm the leader of Children and Family Discipleship at St. Peter in Arlington Heights. Now, perhaps it's the nature lover in me, but these two earthy analogies really resonate with me and influence my teaching style. In fact, we're in the middle of an experiment related to those trees and their good and bad fruit. Each one of my classes got a chance to examine some seeds without knowing what they were, and then they planted them. Now, right now, they have no idea what kind of fruit they're going to produce because most of them aren't really sure what kind of seeds they planted. My question to you is, what kind of seeds are you planting? Not in your garden, but in your heart. My encouragement to you is to continue to spend time in God's Word each day so that you can plant the seeds of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These fruits of the Spirit will grow in your heart the more time you spend with God. And I encourage you also to cast aside any seeds of anger, frustration, resentment, or hate. Now, this passage concludes with another one of my favorite visuals. Anyone who has ever been to the beach and built a sandcastle knows the fragility of their existence. One rogue wave and all of your hard work can be swept away. Jesus tells us that if we hear his word and ignore it, we might as well be living in that sandcastle. We will get swept away into a heap of ruins. However, when we hear the word of God and put it into practice, we have a solid foundation that can withstand all of the storms that life throws at us. How blessed we are to have been given these words to plant in our hearts and shape our lives. It's even more amazing that throughout it all, God is with us, guiding us as we go.